A 50-year-old mathematical mistake that caused a crack in the Wanapum Dam.
That error didn't allow the dam to withstand the tremendous...
In February 2014, we received a phone call from Wanapum Dam letting us know that they had discovered a 65-foot crack in one of their spillway monoliths. And a big chunk of the spillway was actually tilting downstream. Had this monolith failed, it would have been absolutely catastrophic.
So considering the situation, they did the only reasonable thing that they could, and that was to lower the reservoir and take the pressure off of the monolith. This had immediate consequences and implications. There was a major environmental crisis in the making.
It's during moments like these that the true values of the district are on display.
First and foremost on the list of objectives was protecting human health and safety. Operators and engineers performed additional inspections even on weekends. In the event of an emergency, we wanted to have a boat that was already on the river that we could access. We heard employees reminding each other to use the radios so that everybody could hear the conversations that were going on in the plant. Each and every employee had the authority and the duty to stop work in any unsafe condition. Chelan County PUD safety is a core value. It's embedded in everything we do, whether it's an emergency response effort such as Wanapum or if it's day-to-day operations.
We define operational excellence as high-quality, innovative work execution. So one of the first things that happened when we got the call was we needed to form and mobilize the incident command system, which we called the ICS team. The team coordinated a massive collaborative effort to get the right skill sets and resources in the right place at the right time to successfully mitigate against the impacts to hydro operations, fish passage, recreation, and irrigation.
There was an all-time forecasted record run of adult salmon and steelhead headed up the Columbia River from the ocean. Unfortunately, we didn't have fish ladders that were in operation due to the drawdown at Rock Island. And certainly there was an effect on the juvenile fish migration that was headed downriver at the same time. We are stewards of the Columbia River, and it was important that we act appropriately and act immediately. Our employees collaborated with state and federal agencies to design and install extensions to the fish ladders. We altered the spill sequence to make sure the juvenile salmon and steelhead had sufficient water to get downriver to the ocean. Nearly 800,000 adult fish made it safely past Rock Island, and the spring migration of juvenile salmon and steelhead went without interruption. It was absolutely unbelievable it could happen the way it did. This wasn't the only ecological disaster we were facing at the time. We had irrigation intakes that were high and dry, putting at peril thousands of acres of croplands and ripening fruit. Again, the PUD worked very closely and collaboratively with the state and federal agencies and the ag industry to make sure the growers had the water they needed for their crops. In the end, not a single acre of cropland was lost. The lower water level behind Rock Island Dam also put the public boat launches out of operation. There were thousands of people that wanted to get on the reservoir. Our engineers and project managers quickly designed an extension to the Kirby Billingsley Hydro Park boat launch, and boating for fishing, for recreation during the summer and fall went on without a hitch. Chelan County PUD is a good steward of the natural resources that are entrusted in our care. In addition, we are stewards of Chelan PUD's physical assets on behalf of our customer owners, and we take this stewardship role very seriously. We have a long-term perspective about what will create the greatest value for our customer owners. In the example of the Wanapum Dam crisis, our first priority was protecting the hydro projects by shutting down the generating units, only later restoring generation in a very conservative manner. It's critically important that we protect the long-term value of the assets, even if it costs some money in the short term.
These were unprecedented operating conditions. Without the many highly skilled and highly dedicated employees, we wouldn't have been able to accomplish what we did in the amount of time that we had as effectively as we did, and all of that while having the highest safety standards.
Our employees, our customer owners, the other organizations that we partner with know that we can be relied upon to do what we say we will do. Our actions complied with state and federal laws and regulations, our own board resolutions. We also reached out to orchardists, other landowners, and even recreational users, even though we're not obligated to do that. It's easy to see why we are one of the most trusted agencies in the state. This event, which could have damaged our reputation, ended up strengthening the trust of the community in us.
The values guide us and help us to be focused on doing the right things every day. They enable us to be an incredible asset for Chelan County.
It really makes me proud to think about the response of this organization, the other organizations that we partner with, and the knowledge and the expertise and the dedication and the hours and hours of work to make sure that this came out well for everyone.